Hey guys, Workerverse, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 PSV career mode. Where I didn't upload on Monday. I know I'm the most horrible person ever. I should be uploading every single day like I want to and like I've said I would do. But can't always be done. It can't always be that way. Hey. Sometimes things will come up that will allow me to record. I'll just be like, one day off isn't gonna fucking kill me. And, that was my thought process. And
should have a fine game for you today. Yeah. Welcome to it. Martin Tyler
so
here, along with Alan.
I didn't upload on Monday.
PSV Eindhoven.
And
today,
if you watched yesterday's look,
Jasper de Vaart is the man in charge.
100 episodes. I talked about possibly being
the PSV. This is how they'll play today. Hector Moreno starts with Nicolas Isamara in the heart of the defense.
Completely forgetting I had some
attacker in the lineup. Prepper.
And now incapable of doing it.
Well, they're in a good position here.
Well, it's a nice skill. Double uploads will have to come on.
It's woeful. That attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance.
Friday.
Team well.
And next month. You know what I mean? I can't do a double upload. Trust me, I had something to do.
Well, this is where you want to come to see goals. The performance of the players from the home side this season, when they've been playing here at home, they're unstoppable.
We had that.
Yeah, these home fans have been
treating
to some fantastic football and great goals.
You will get the double on Friday. And
on to the attack now. Here comes the challenge.
On Friday.
So we've got a corner coming up. Via that tackle.
On Friday and Monday.
See what footwear the teams are going to actually use today.
Rain
is coming down. Might have to change what they originally started with.
And I think sometimes with the lads wearing blades these days, you do see them slipping
tomorrow,
a bit. And
I was planning
to have to change halfway through this match.
Double.
This is one of the best runs that this club have been on the home team for a long, long time. Consecutive victories, chance
and
to make it 10.
Every chance the season review slash transfer target.
But the way that the back four is defending, they look a really good unit.
The shot's on! Has to score!
Plan.
And a goal!
Since the season review. For longer. You know, I'm in the
to make your mouth water. Great goal.
A really good save, but that's when he needs the help of his defenders.
Let's have another peek at that goal.
Today's thing, though, I didn't realize, I almost completely forgot, will be carrying over till tomorrow. Now, I can't say for sure that it might cause there to be no double upload. But
return ball.
Second upload may have to wait until Saturday. The season review may have to wait until Saturday. So, I was kind of hoping there would be like some
could be dangerous
transfer reveal.
Set it up well for the cross.
Talk about.
And here's the header.
I don't know how long the season review slash transfer target video is going to be.
Distance, but the keeper.
I honestly do not know how long it's going to be. Anyway, if I'm brutally honest, there's a man going through talking about every single player. If they play at least one game last season,
to get away from the defender.
Shots on here. Oh boy, did Liverpool play back. Yeah, Park's line.
Add to their lead.
And of course, there'll be the transfer for Target as well.
Good defending.
Now, you might think, should I be really doing it as one video? It'd be better because if I try to do it as two videos, I'll just be like,
cross. And he's up for the header. Oh, what a fine goal.
I'll lose all interest.
Two now. Feel a bit more comfortable.
It's easier for me.
Disadvantage at the moment. Not there when needed. The goalkeeper,
you know,
as it turned out. No, one or two of these defenders looking at him, having words, and you can understand.
They're doing two separate videos. Let's lump these together because they are kind of related. Talking about how the season went last season.
Oh, I spotted the pass.
And how the season. And how to better that next season with our planned moves in the transfer. And like I did for my little exposure video
from
a while back, if you guys remember, on Dragon Ball Z, I will be.
Well, they're in a good position.
It'll be a rare video where I will allow comments, because I just want them to gauge the opinions of the people who watch that video, because I expect to get people who actually.
Well, that's half time.
I want. Because I expect people to watch that video whose opinions will actually matter.
Shown that they can score. We know that they can do that, but it's still plenty in the game.
Some random bullshit about, oh, the career mode's unrealistic. Oh, you're using sliders. Oh, you're pretending it's on legendary. Blah, blah, blah. Some bullshit like that. I just don't need on my career mode videos. Because why should I have that on my comments when I've
was moving again for the start of the second half
over and over again? I am on that.
PSV
with the slider. I'm just good. People just don't accept that I'm good.
Andres,
you know what? I really don't. I've been playing FIFA
some danger
for longer than most. I'm playing career mode ever since I first picked up a controller and turned on a FIFA game. But if I... Why would I use sliders? I've said it before, if I were to use sliders, I would play legendary harder because they don't release... It then... harder to legendary.
It's attacked very well.
Now, when I was younger, I played on a lure. As I grew up, I slowly, gradually took steps harder until
trying to find a way through here, probing away. Andres Guardado.
And unless FIFA 18 is going to introduce a new
is eased on his goal. The substitute coming on.
The career mode difficulty, which I think should.
Not perhaps the best cross.
If Ultimate Team can have Ultimate,
now the shot.
Career mode should have something.
Well wide.
Even if you just want to use Ultimate, it doesn't have to be just for Ultimate Team, just because you call it Ultimate.
His defenders can close him down a bit quicker because he has been peppering them in and scored.
The funny thing is, I struggle against Ultimate. I really do. I struggle against Ultimate. If I play against Ultimate, I've lost far more games against Ultimate.
Over. And the goalkeeper
is left hidden there. ultimate
will be a corner.
It's been around for a few FIFAs now. I don't know if I'll ever get used to ultimate. And yet, here I am asking for a
stop
for ultimate to be put onto career mode. Or
he's one possession
to be, or for career mode to be given its own equivalent to Ultimate Team's Ultimate, because I want a challenge. Yeah, it's all well and good. It would be better for everything, you know? It would make my videos more interesting. You just would, you wouldn't go into it saying, "Ah, oh, I know he's gonna win these games."
Corner count to this point.
Because you are expect that, or you think I'm bullshitting about being on
the right area, and then
I'm being on legendary, or
but the attackers will be delighted,
or that I'm bullshitting about being about not using slide.
What a great goal that was, Alan. Well, it was such a beautifully delivered corner that you just felt it was going to end up.
Given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
See the point. Well, I want a challenge. I want this game.
Thought quickly as well.
I've often thought about
attacking now.
But
shots on here. He's blocked the shot well.
Normally I'll be talked out of or I'll decide. It wouldn't really be a challenge.
9 minutes now.
Because it would be like the opposition would be on steroids.
He wants to make a substitution now. And here's the
I could
his stock in trade.
For all intents and purposes, use the sliders in the game to make the legendary harder. I know how they work. I've seen them used. Use them a few FIFAs ago. Oh, I did try them out just to see how they work for myself. But I never used the main tour. But I have thought about making legendary a little more difficult with the use of the sliders. But then I decide it wouldn't be the same as a higher difficulty. It would be just legendary on steroids, which I mean you could argue a higher difficulty, an upgrade. Legendary. Anyway, it'd be like facing legendary on steroids. But legendary does some stupid shit.
He went in well.
I would hope that if they introduce a new higher difficulty
into the attacking mode,
the AI might be a bit smarter.
They
might
make first
better decisions.
Because the final whistle goes. 3-0, a very comprehensive best run.
You find that moment where the AI makes a massive balls up decision and just completely fucks up. He's just like, what? Why? Why did that happen? I mean, you're happy because you get an advantage of the opposition, but so I hopefully I've made that clear. No, hopefully I have. Probably not, but anyway, I will be using two videos in one sort of thing, and comments will be allowed for that video. And, yeah. Just, making sure everybody's clear on how things will be going over the next couple of days. So you know when to expect the video. Well, you know what day to expect the video. That I'm saying you will get, which you will. I always, like, unless something comes up, that's always my mentality. I want to upload unless something comes up or I'm just not feeling up to it or something.
Alan Smith is with me. I'm Martin Tyler. Delighted to have you.
I always struck to give.
They've been at it right from the first game of the season. I must say they've been very impressive and untouchable so far.
Well, they have
outclassed wonderful
opponents. And deservedly, there's a good deal of daylight between themselves and second place. Can they hold on to it?
This is the lineup for the home side.
The, 4-3-3. Content and the.
They've got natural wide players
and
the
level
in
of consistency
with a central striker.
I think that's the key, because those lads on the flanks, it's quite a complicated job actually, because they've got to come inside, support the centre forward, and they've also got to funnel back when.
And shoots! Saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch. Marking as tightly as they can. This corner could be a problem. They've got to defend it well.
So. That's everything, I think, and now focus on the second game here for this episode.
It's good play until they got that challenge in. PSV, and now the shot. Well, he's put it away.
Lokeia scores once again. What a goal! Oh, well.
He reacted perfectly, really sharp right from the off, and they've taken the lead here. Really well hit, really well directed.
Well, we say it so often, but I think that one was truly unstoppable for the keeper.
So the first
top corner as well, because, you know,
Schmidt. There's going to be a throw-in after that tackle.
I mentioned briefly, if you
widen
missed...
The play, really, widen the build-up, but the ball just runs straight out over the touchline.
Go watch really it, I did that. I talked a little bit about
progress.
The news that was revealed about FIFA 18.
So now a goal kick to come. Well, we can see
Man,
that well, goal again.
Watching the FIFA 18 trailer,
I think he hit it with
Will. You're like, wow, it's almost time for FIFA 18. Not already.
This is an exercise in patience as they try to get an opening. Goodness, they needed him then to clear that.
I'm probably going to be pre-ordering FIFA.
David Prepper. Now he's looking for support. And he's up for the header.
On the aerial. I'll let you know when I have
to show for it.
Well, we've seen plenty of headed goals from this lad, but putting that to the collection there.
Nah.
Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Yeah.
Back with PSV Eindhoven now.
I will have to wait and see what new leagues are in. If there are any new leagues being added to FIFA 18, because there's always a chance that this might be the year. For since they keep snatching every player they can get their hands on, the Chinese Super League might just be out.
The shot's on! They can't get past him here. That's really fantastic defending with the tackle. Gone out over the touchline. That'll be a throw to the opposition. On to the attack now. And in goes the cross. And he's met it with his head. Great stop. Corner given.
No, no. I'm trying to think of what early.
And he heads it for goal. That is his.
I'm sure there's leagues that they have.
The ball to attack. Probably thought he should have scored.
Already.
Yeah, there was enough of the goal to aim at there. Gotta go down as a miss.
I don't think they have the Welsh or Northern Ireland. I know they have the Artristi, which is the Republic of Ireland.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition.
I don't
now
think
they're here.
The Welsh and Northern Ireland.
Shots on here. Got the ball back.
So those could be.
It'll be a throw in here for PSV.
I don't think Pez has the licensing to those leagues. I could be wrong.
No goal.
Dude, you're looking right over at the linesman. You can't see him holding the flag. You dense fuck.
Well, this must have been very tight indeed, but we get the advantage of another look that the officials, of course, don't.
No, and it was such a close call, but the defence had squeezed and caught the lad offside, although he took to...
Wonderful chance! Very good stop here.
I forgot.
With the throw. Prepper doing well to keep the ball. And here's the cross. And it's a heading chance.
Yes. No.
It's a good save. He got a touch to that. With this goal advantage, they've now got a corner.
Come on, win the header. Of course not. I'm trying to think. Wait. Most leagues they already have.
4 extra minutes to play here.
Is what new stadium will be added.
Fine moment for them. They've got a firm.
I mean, we already know that the Brighton Stadium and the Huddersfield Stadium are definitely the going to be in the game because those two teams are promoted to the Premier League. And in case anyone was like, oh, you forgot Newcastle. Newcastle's stadium's already in
the anticipation as well, wasn't it? Just to get in front of his man.
Previous.
Restarting at two.
It didn't get taken out just because they went down. And nor will this. The stadiums of Hull, Hull Sunderland, and Middlesbrough. So, good news, Middlesbrough fans, even though you got relegated, your stadium is still in FIFA, so there's that, you know? So jump on FIFA 18 and get your team back to the Premier League. You can do it!
And it's PSV kicking off.
Of course it won't make any difference in real life, but you know.
Played down the wing, keeping the wide attack going. Well, they're building steadily here, working away. Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. He's certainly been an influence on this first half.
I would be happy with that first 45 minutes. It was a good goal from him. Good overall performance, actually.
In quickly.
One has to wonder, will Barcelona's stadium be back, or do... I don't know if Pez still have the licensing.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
We'll have to wait and see on that one. Acted
very promptly and decisively. Oh, he's through. Shot up! No, no!
Oh my god, how did I miss that? How did I miss that?
Because they've been left for dead, but he just couldn't finish it.
Anyway, a horrific miss aside.
An hour of very good football here. We've still got 30 more minutes to go, and I'm sure we're going to enjoy that as well. Well, he's beaten his man. Tackle is strong. Now Larsen.
It would be nice to see them get the licensing to use the actual real names of leagues and tournaments, like, so we can stop calling the Champions League the Champions Cup. Seriously, it's really annoying that. You know what it is. The trophy looks the exact same. It doesn't look any different. It's the same competition.
Marvellous piece of work in the tackle. Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go.
I don't know how long Pez has the licensing to that, but whenever comes available, EA should move heaven and earth to get it.
And they've cut it out. Guardado.
I mean,
this is how they love to.
I'll be honest, I didn't think they'd ever add legends to the PS4. Son of a bitch, they are. The way they get around that little caveat is, don't call them legends, call them icons. Because, same thing.
Although, when you go to ground like that with a slide tackle of getting into.
And this was pointed out to me by one of my followers on Twitter. The players who get icon cards will probably. The icon cards will still be classed in, like, the legend standpoint, but the icon
stylishly
it'll be like this are iconic because of this and that.
Really cool strike that.
If Henri is in the game, he'll be classed as a legend, as an Arsenal icon. I mean, they've huge fucking statue to do that from side of the air. I think he's classed that guy as an icon.
3-0 as the game gets underway.
Yeah, just saying.
Spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this attack.
Ronaldo, he'll be classed as an icon of Real Madrid, more than likely, because as well his
a timely challenge
in the promotional stuff, they have him in his Real Madrid jersey, even though he played for Barcelona, both Milan clubs. Dude got around.
It was good progress with this attack,
and somehow never got tripped.
And shoots.
Labeled a traitor,
shot well,
which is odd.
The defenders, they keep conceding these, like, corners.
He played for both sides of Milan in Derby and both sides of El Clasico, and yet I've never heard him branded a traitor. Like,
well, they've decided to make a change. There's activity.
If you went to Real Madrid fan, say, what is your thought on Ronaldo? You'd have to classify, of course, that you're talking about R9 Ronaldo, not CR7, or what, they'll be like, Cristiano? No. R9 Ronaldo. Oh, R9 Ronaldo. Oh, he's great.
On the corner count.
Or he was great. He's not a player anymore. He doesn't play anymore.
From the goalkeeper to make that kind of save.
You don't deserve a trip.
It's going to continue here. We've got 4 minutes of added time. On the attack here.
You'd never hear of that. Like, no. Granted, I'd never met. I haven't met
comprehensive win by 3-0. That's the final whistle.
Real Madrid fans.
3-3.
Well, any diehard Real Madrid fans. So maybe I've been. Maybe that's down to people you know. But even in the football world, even if you don't support those clubs, if a player leaves a club, he's branded as a traitor. Like Fabian Delph or Raheem Sterling, or Robin van Persie. Those players were labeled as snakes and traitors, but Ronaldo, he's not looked at like that. I'm not putting those players on his level. Like maybe van Persie, when he was as good, it was a top class striker. Fabian Delph killed his career, and rightfully so, and Raheem Sterling can burn in hell. But R9 Ronaldo seemingly never got branded it as a traitor. And clearly, he can see that as the case as well, because they branded him an icon. And more or less, they branded him a Real Madrid icon. Which people are like, yeah. Because when you think of R9 Ronaldo, Real Madrid is the club you think of. Even if you know he did play for those other clubs, you never think he did play for Barcelona, though. You always think Real Madrid legend. Real Madrid icon. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Hey, smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.